Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. A new Q&A is here. Let's go through them, shall we? Mark 1 and 2 jets. Is it possible that JSM-2 will receive any new missiles in the future, such as a PL-5 or PL-7? Will the MiG-21 also get any new improved missiles too? If these missiles were historically mounted on these versions of the aircraft, then it is possible. The problem with the MiG-21 and newer missiles is that the newer missiles were not put on the current version of the aircraft, since these missiles require new pylons. Now, this is true. This is absolutely true. There's nothing wrong with that. If they, in real life, had these, then they should be given to them. The problem with the MiG-21 and newer missiles is that newer missiles were not put on the current versions of the aircraft, since these missiles require new pylons. This is 90% true. I mean, if they, in real life, didn't have these, then don't give it to them. But yeah, this last bit, how much of an effect pylons have, but I think it's not that big of a deal. It's not about the right pylon. It's about whether their vehicles are capable of firing and locking on and all that kind of gizmo and gadget stuff. The MiG-21 F-13 is quite restricted in its armament. Is it possible we will see a later variant with more weapons? For sure, we plan on several more versions of the MiG-21 and we are already working on them. We understand that the current version is limited in capability, but it was widespread version that took part in different war conflicts, so we decided to start with it as, in some ways, a cult vehicle. Yep, the MiG-21 F-13 is very, very limited. One of the reasons why I don't look forward to getting it in the game. And you just got confirmation that more of them are being developed right now. So, they're gonna come. Just hold your horses. Don't jump to conclusions very much. The current one is limited, but we took it as... We started out with the widespread. I mean, why exactly did you start out with the MiG-21? Why couldn't you just add the Su-15s, 17s? You know, still Mach 1 capable jets. Why not start out with them? Was it so difficult to add them? Was it not interesting enough to add them? They should have left Mach 2 jets for a while. They shouldn't be added right now, in all honesty. But yeah, more MiG-21s are coming. Just hold on, okay? I'm in no rush to getting them. Now, we are getting even more modern aircraft that can burn through their entire fuel load significantly faster. The need for external fuel drop tanks has really become significant. Lots of aircraft in the game would benefit from such a feature. Are there any plans for this? Due to the reasons described above, we are not going to exclude this possibility. Sure, why not? Fuel tanks will make things interesting. They will look cool. The fuel tanks are miscellaneous. They're not really necessary. I mean, I run 30 minutes of fuel in my top tier jets. I don't run anything higher. Any higher is completely unnecessary. Battles don't last that long. I don't last that long. And it will have an effect if you go take full fuel load. 30 minutes is more or less enough. I mean, we'll still see what happens next. Fuel tanks is gonna be a cool feature, I gotta say. And it'll look great in cinematics, if anyone wanna make cinematics. But other than that, yeah, fuel tank is not that big of a deal. I mean, come on. But still, they're gonna be cool. If they're gonna add it, add them. France could really use a competitive top rank aircraft, as the Super Mystère has suffered from some time. Is it possible we could see the French F-100 as a temporary solution before later French aircraft are dirty? The Mirage is planned for sure, and it is already in development like some other French aircraft, but we will consider this proposal. So, I guess the French used the F-100s as well. Now, listen, I don't have a problem with copy-paste vehicles. If other nations used vehicles exactly the same, I don't mind them. But, yeah, I still prefer to grind something new other than just something that, I mean, I just played the F-100 a few weeks ago. Like, several weeks ago, I fully spaded my F-100. I've been playing the F-100 for quite a long time now. And it's a good jet, but I'm not interested in grinding another F-100. Like, come on. As much as there's no problem with copypasta vehicles, yeah, there's still a problem with copypasta vehicles. It's a 45 to 55% difference. 45% of the time I want copypasta vehicles, 55% of the time I'm not interested in them. On the other note, they just confirmed that the Mirage is being planned and it's in development. So, you French boys, I think it's time for you to stop retreating and start moving forward. The Mirages are gonna come sooner. They're gonna come, don't worry about them, okay? Until then, just hold out. Stay patient. Is it possible we will see a full Chinese helicopter in Naval 3 in the future? Yes, we plan. We have plans for Chinese helicopter research tree. This will not be such a hard task due to an already good amount of vehicles which we can choose from. Also, China has their own domestic design helicopters. With the Naval Research Tree, which we also have plans, it is an entirely opposite situation and hence more complex. I can wait for Chinese helicopters and ships. Even though I don't play helicopters and ships, that's a lot, but I can wait. No biggie. They can easily, they said it right here, it's not that big of a deal, and they have plenty of helicopters. The Navy is a problem for them, so we'll see what happens. I have no history and knowledge on this type of thing, so yeah, we'll see what happens. Are any more Vietnamese or North Korean variants of vehicles as possible candidates for the Chinese tree? We are not excluding that, but at the moment there are no details. More premiums. I mean, there should be only just one premium for each rank, and they should only be used for grinding purposes, not as a player purpose or something. I don't want Vietnamese or Korean vehicles as premiums. If they're coming in the standard tree that we all can play, then yeah, definitely. I would like them to be added. The British helicopter tree is rather small in comparison to all the other nations' main branches, with most nations having at least 5 to 6 available for research in the main branch alone, and Britain having only 3. Given that the Scout and Wasp are almost identical and rather low in performance ordnance choices, do you plan to work on British helicopters to balance out the tree numerically with the other nations? Yes, we plan to develop the British helicopters research tree in the future. I honestly don't know why this type of question is even asked. Like, for sure they're gonna be arriving someday. They're not gonna be neglected all the time. Come on. I hate helicopters. I don't like helicopters. They can go frick themselves. Are there any limitations behind the Westland Gazelle AH Mark 1? And not being included. The British tested it with weaponry, and the Westland version was capable of mounting everything that the French aerospatial variants, even if they did not in service just like that, the German helicopters have American-Mexican weaponry options available to use in-game. Gazelles were deployed, used in Falcons with 68mm snaps, at least by the British. Is it possible for the future? Weirdly worded question. The main problem is that, according to our information, British Gazelles were armed with only 2x6 snap 68mm rocket units, which in total provides only 12 rockets. This is extremely small by the game standards, considering only volley fire is relatively effective. The other photos we have of these helicopters are contradictory because they show ATGM suspension without control equipment. We continue to search for information and will be grateful for any help on the matter. In the meantime, we are considering other options for the British branch. For example, the Westland Wessex. It is noticeably different from its American ancestor and carries a variety of weapons. That's a big answer and a big question, but other than that, yeah, there's your answer. I'm not really fond with helicopters right now. Based on this answer, it only has 12 rockets. Like, how are you gonna even be effective with that amount? And the ATGM thing, I have no real-life knowledge about this, so we'll see what happens. The British are gonna get their helicopters. Don't worry about them. We have many new aircraft and helicopters with multiple loadout configurations. Is it possible you will rework the loadout system to be more clear and efficient? Such as a modular loadout selection that allows you to see all the options more clearly. We understand the problem and agree that aircraft with a large number of suspended weaponry presets isn't very convenient and easy to see. So we plan to improve the system in the future. Thank freaking God! Please remake the goddamn preset system. I am tired of presets. I don't want presets anymore. They're confusing. Hard to look at. Some aircraft have a certain preset, and the next step, the bigger brother, which is 90% similar. For example, I'm gonna bring in the F-84B. It can mount 2 tiny teams separately on its own preset. And the F-84G, its next variant, it cannot mount the 2 tiny teams as its own separate preset. Why? Why can the B variant, with a weaker engine, able to mount 2 tiny teams alone, whereas the better variant with the better engine cannot mount the tiny teams on its own? It has to be mounted with the HWARs as well. Why? Presets are not interesting enough for me. Make a custom window where in the hangar when we select secondary weapons, or when we select weapons, they should add a new tab in the hangar menu. Weapons. We click on weapons, a window opens up. We get a selection of weapons right on the left. We get a selection of weapons. Okay, we get a selection of weapons, and selection of weapons designating that this aircraft is capable of mounting these weapons in total. Is capable of mounting these weapons. The Tiny Tim, HWARS, gun parts, bombs, stuff like that. On the right side, just on the right side, it shows a weight limit. This aircraft is capable of mounting 2 tons of ordnance, 3 tons of ordnance, 5 tons of ordnance, stuff like that. We click and hold the weapon and mount them and just drag over the plane, and it mounts automatically on the pylon, whichever it's able to mount on. We should only be limited by weight and the pylon to which that particular weapon can be mounted on. Please rework this preset system. It is not convenient, not efficient at all, and it is inconsistent. Now that we have more modern aircraft, can you please introduce new, larger, and modern AI aircraft carriers with angled flight decks that can properly accommodate jets and top-tier maps? We are still operating from pre-war carriers in extremely post-war aircraft now. Yes, we have plans to design new aircraft carriers on which we can normally use post-war jets. Absolutely, that should be the case. I'm glad this question has been asked and answered. I don't know who answered this. I don't know who asked this. I don't care. Thank you for making new aircraft carriers. Please make them. I'm tired of landing on Langleys and whatever. Since they are now premium helicopters with air-to-air missiles, is it possible you can improve helicopter battles in during competition matchmaking so that people with only first early helicopters like AH-1G, MI-4, AH-34, Scout, WASP, and LOA-2 don't have to face fully advanced air-to-air capable helicopters like Eurocopter, AH-1Z, MI-35M, and Lynx? They are almost impossible to counter with lower rank helicopters. This is a very hard task to This is a very hard task in reality when taking into account the low popularity of purely helicopter battles. However, we are exploring possible solutions for this problem. Yes, this is a giant problem. Like a stock vehicle versus a fully upgraded vehicle, or just a mildly upgraded vehicle, is a big difference. These helicopters mentioned right here, they have no chances against these top tier ones with missiles, man. How are you supposed to exactly play? Especially in an open environment. Enduring competitions happen in open environment. How are you able to play like that? You can't even go ground striking because you're not gonna be doing anything. Nobody is gonna let you ground strike. You're gonna get AAM from 5 kilometers away. You're lucky if you survive one missile. Most of these helicopters can mount 4 of them at a time. How are you supposed to dodge them? As for a very hard task to do, like, how hard can it be to determine that this helicopter in his account, and these are the upgrades, and he's going into matchmaking right now? Why is it so difficult to discriminate him out of the queue so that he doesn't face against these lower vehicles? How hard can that be? Do something about it. I really don't have any interest in playing helicopters because of this reason. I played several enduring competitions, and that's exactly what happens to me. And the fact that RP per module is very high. Stock helicopters just get unguided rockets, which are not enough. Absolutely not enough. Overall, yeah, these are some good questions asked. The Mirage is coming. The MiG-21 next versions are coming. More weaponry are possible if they are mounted in real life. I'm okay with copypasta vehicles, and at the same time, I'd rather just grind out something new. I don't care that much about helicopters. I really don't. Navy is a bit more fun compared to helicopters right now. So yeah, Chinese Navy and helicopter will come soon enough. I don't really want to see different nationalities as premiums in current tech trees. Like, we have enough premiums for now. Okay? I swear to God, I want to see the Vickers Mark 7. The Vickers MBT Mark 7. I want to see these vehicles as standard tree vehicles. I don't want to see them as premiums. British helicopters are coming. Don't worry about them. Please make a better secondary weapon option. Please, please, please. I'm begging you. This is a really good question and a really good answer. Please make this a reality. I want a new, simpler, and custom window system. New aircraft carriers, absolutely. No questions about it. And yes, please do something about lower tiers. A stock vehicle versus a top tier vehicle, they should please do something about it. Not just about helicopters, but for planes, tanks as well, and for ships. I wrote my comment over here, so if you guys are seeing this, let's see what other comments are there. Wow, there are no questions answered for Jabs Tech Tree again. For real, I am starting to think that the tech tree is abandoned. No, it is not abandoned, please. For the love of Christ. Japanese have enough vehicles right now. If you're worried that if you're done researching it or something, or if you're tired of playing it, then I can understand that. But please, for the love of Christ, it is good enough for now. What we need is parity. We need Japanese Mark II jets. We need Japanese IFVs. We need tank destroyers, heavy tanks. We'll push for questions in for the Japanese tech tree next Q&A. There you have it. Don't worry about the Japanese. Come on, their tree is well developed enough. As for parity systems, some SPAs or something. When will we see ROC flag again? Again? It's in the decal customization area. He means the ROC flags on the vehicles, like the CM11. You knew what he meant. I don't know the exact controversy, but yes, I do agree. If things are historical, keep them historical. If this game is based on history, keep history in it. Why are you taking history out of it? China complains about it, then yeah, there's nothing you can do about it. What about British supersonic jets? Stay tuned to the news. I firmly believe that something new is coming next update for the British top tier jets. There has to be. There's no way there isn't any. There has to be. If it doesn't come, then it's a big problem. But I think it's coming. Don't worry about it. So a lot of planned and not a lot of action as per usual then. Ghost shells aren't fixed. There is severe lack of World War II content along with this high tier premium spam, the hit camera damage text doesn't match up anymore, a lot of interaction problems between shell and armor, and a ton of exploit positions on the map that you really shouldn't be able to get into. Break the match. Can we please just fix the game first instead of non-stop adding new things that only breaks, no fun allowed. The dev team fixed around 1,000 bugs between each major. They're working really hard to fix the game, and in effect, we're having less and less bugs than before. But as old bugs are removed, it put focus on the ones remaining. As for the lack of World War II content, we have a lot of World War II vehicles. Sure, we're adding more modern ones, often recently, but do not erase what was done before. Exactly. They are working on fixing the game, slowly but surely. It might not look enough, it might not feel enough, but they are working for it. They're fixing, you get changelog. Why did you forget that they do changelogs every now and then? Those mini changelog patches, 150 MBs and stuff like that. Bugs and everything. Now sure, they might be annoying. I really hate them. But they happen. It's a game. It's a software. It's gonna happen. Sooner or later. And one bug gets fixed, another one arises up. So the problem will last forever. There will never be a perfect game unless... Yeah, it's gonna be a perfect game, whatever. As for World War II content, what are you talking about? Every nation's rank 3 has World War II content. World War II stretches to rank 4 and a few of them at rank 5. Now yes, they have been adding a new modern stuff, but that's where they're gonna go. A lot of people care about modern vehicles. Sure, we care about World War II and all that, but majority of the audience are pivoted towards modern vehicles, so they're gonna give modern vehicles a bit more attention compared to World War II now. But they do add World War II and lower tier vehicles every now and then. You just got a devlog about the French weird looking bullfighter and ugly duckling. The hit camera, yes, I do agree, it doesn't match anymore. For some reason, the hit camera doesn't match. I don't know why. Please fix that bug. It's really annoying that sometimes it doesn't matches and sometimes it does. Please fix that. And ghost shells, yes, I do get one or two ghost shell occasionally. Please fix that. Other than that, I can't do really anything other than just speak my words. There's enough World War II content in the game right now. You can have fun. If you're tired of playing, don't be like that. There's plenty of World War II content in here. That's the Q&A for 18th of October 2019. That's basically it. All the questions. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Like if you like, dislike if you dislike, subscribe for more content, and I'll see you next time.